Hello everyone, this is JCrazy614 and welcome back to my playthrough of Dragon Quest VII. And today we're going to try to save this village from a volcano. But first I gotta talk to Palmela. And yes, Palmela, I believe your vision's true because we had the same thing. So maybe our thoughts are in sync. Suspect something's happening. But we won't be able to know for sure until we actually get up there. Well, I would say so. I think Flame Slash isn't going to work out as well. So let's talk to the mayor. Well, let's get to the mirror first. Alright. So you believe everything's gonna be okay? Well, if we do something about it, everything will be okay. Basically, I'm pressing the B button to be able to talk to myself, but I guess you can't convince me. Alright, so basically we gotta sleep at the inn to get this sequence started. So let's go ahead and do that. Because the festival, we get a free night's sleep. Now, if I wanted to do some grinding, this would have been an okay time to do so. You know, get a little extra experience. And then go to sleep. But after this, you won't be able to go to bed. But really the best time, the grind would have been to do all this without talking to the mayor or Palmela. Especially if you need that whip. But luckily I got the whip already. I could talk to all the villagers, but I really don't want to. Alright, so Palmela's really focused. So let's see if I can find the mayor. Oh, well, the gaffer. I don't know if it's one of those things where I gotta talk to all the villagers to trigger something. I forget. Already in at the table. Yeah, here he is. Oh yeah, we're having a good time. Right, I'm gonna talk to Palmela, see if this triggers anything. Alright, so basically you're just gonna wait till... Oh! Looks like things are getting started. Ah, so that's what it is. Everyone wears these little hats with a flame on top of them. And on the PS1 version, they were carrying torches. Well, you know, this feels a bit more festive. Although, one wonders why wearing a flame on top of the head is any better. Probably better to carry a torch than to wear a hat with a flame on top of it. Yeah, we're ready. Volcano. We finally get to go to the volcano. If we find out the braziers. I think that's what they're called, braziers. If you ever know what the name of those pedestals where the fires are called, please let me know in the comments. Yeah, let's get up there now. There's a fragment in this area as well. Well, I don't like waiting in line. We need to get up there now. We need to stop that volcano from erupting. No one's around the cutting line, but the fate of the world, the fate of this island is in our hands. We have to dish people. We have to cut in line. You may not like it now, but once you realize that we're stopping a volcano from erupting and killing everyone, think it's worth it. Think they'll realize it. Yeah, we were just trying to save the island. Following you up here this whole time. Now, of course, before we can do anything, we ourselves have to take part in this ritual. Basically, we throw our hats into the volcano. Yeah, we're ready to save the island. We're ready to save Emberdale. You said it, Keeper. Now, if I remember from the PS1 version of this, there's kind of a time limit into how. Oh. Before. Alright. What I was saying was, in the PS1 version, there was a bit of a time limit as to how long you could take in the volcano before it would erupt, and I think it was triggered by how many times you used the stairs. Now, I've only played through this once on the 3DS, and I'm not sure if that same time limit trigger is in effect. because every few sets of stairs you go up and down, it triggers a villager throwing their hat into the volcano. Their fire hat. Also, if... Wait, I don't... Alright, now I'm gonna go down this first set of stairs. And there's a set of stairs to the right, but I'm not gonna go down though. That's by going up against some choppy hoppers and a mouse flap. Well, luckily, Flame Slash will still work on these guys. And, ooh, you gotta love that Flame Whip. Ooh, Mouse Flap dropped a medicinal herb. Now, what I'm doing... Ooh, I got a couple of Seeds of Resilience. I'll use them on myself. And I'm gonna give Maribel a couple of medicinal herbs. Lava, shabby cake. They're too stunned to move, meaning we get a free turn of attacks. Luckily, Flame Slash will still work on them. Alright, there we go. I think three sets of stairs I went down. And yeah, I don't know when this timer will actually end. And it was a dead end, so I wasted a set of stairs. I should have went up instead. Same set of enemies as before. Well, gotta watch out for that dust. It can blind you. Well, it has the effect of temporarily lowering your accuracy. There we go, chopping hoppers. And gain a level. Oh, it was Maribel. That's good. And looks like we got a new enemy here. Little devils! I think Flame Slash will still work on him. And that's why I got the whip. It can hit multiple enemies as long as they're in the same group. However, these guys are a bit strong. Man, I need to heal Maribel quick. Well, luckily I gave her some medicinal herbs. I'm going to heal Kiefer as well. I probably should have brought bought some medicinal herbs, so if this doesn't work out, I'll probably do this all over again. You got Emmy stuck in the wall. And shabby cats. Yeah, and while the damage may not be great with that form whip, it adds up in the end. Yeah, it has a dazzle effect. That's what it's called. And I don't want to use it for MP. I want to try and save some for Sap. Those little devils are strong. I think I didn't set myself up well in this random encounter. No, semi-random. Monster ran range and... This is a chest. A seed of resilience. That's good. Normally I give it to my hero, but Maribel needs some resilience herself. She's taking double digit damage on those devils. Oh. And our new enemy, Bubble Slime. You gotta watch out for them, they can poison you. So I'm gonna put them to sleep. Ah, nice, it worked. Oh no, dazzle effect. All of them are dazzled. I'm gonna heal myself up. Oh well. I'm not gonna get a chance to use it on the boss, but I might as well frizz. Yes, you can miss. They woke up. Yeah, you can miss a sleeping enemy when down. Yeah, that bubble, I think, is what causes the poison attack. No, poison status. I should put the shabby cat in there. The shabby cat is sweet. So far I've been lucky to not get poisoned. Oh! Well, there went that. I'm gonna use the antidote on Jack, even though I... She can finally see. Well, now everyone can see now. I wonder if I made a mistake going down that. I can always go back into the volcano once everything's done. Hmm. great. You again. Run. Yeah, I decided to run because I'm not dealing with those devils. I'm also not going to deal with these shabby cats. They don't notice. So, I'm just going to take this opportunity to run. That's great. Eat these. Oh, now they block me. If I can't run away, I might as well fight them. Yeah, I'm gonna get rid of Shadow Cat first before I even think about healing. Great. Just great. Well, I'm gonna have to heal and be able to attack this being. Luckily, magic goes through such an effect. And there goes that choppy hopper. And I gained a level. Alright, Jack's at level 8. He learns Zoom, which is very useful. Well, not in this world it's not, but in our time it will be. You gotta be kidding me here. Can't seem to run from anything now. What? Wrong spell. I want snooze. It's working out now. And now I need to heal. There we go. Now I won't need 20 slash to finish this one off. Go work, Maribel. Oh, great. Just great. I hate this passage! I'm just gonna focus on the shabby cat. I should probably start editing out these random encounters. That way, the videos won't be as long. Here's another new random account. Quillers! Yeah, there's really nothing to worry about here. Whoa, pretty strong on defense. And looks like I'm gonna have to heal Maribel up. And obviously that flame slash did more damage, so obviously they take more damage from magic attack. I guess. Now, the reason for this long trek? The Divine Dagger! Can I equip it? Yes, I can. Now it's time to go back through the volcano. Alright, they can't see us, so let's run. And another villager throws his hat in. More chopping hoppers. Luckily, the one that attacked me wasn't the one I went after. Alright, now I'm able to at least two-shot all these guys. I was able to run away. I wanted to be sure if there was a treasure there or not. I just want to get through these mouse plants real quick. I'm trying to remember if they have an attack with their stingers or not. Oh, I missed one, but the other one is done. Looks like I gained a level. Oh, come on. Now I feel like they're just running right into me. At this point, we're just gonna fall right into the volcano. Looks like someone else here to throw their hat in. Think we're gonna cut this close. Alright, nothing. Alright, I think this room. I want to check and see if there's a chest down there. Oh, come on. Thank you. Thank you for running away. Yeah, there are a couple chests here. Got 110 gold. And an anecdotal herb. Yeah, I'll keep the herb with me. I remember if there's something else. Yeah, there is a circle of light. And what this tile does is it regenerates our HP and MP to max. Oh, somehow going to the menu and outdid that. Gonna drop a little bit further. Another villager. I should have counted how many villagers there were so that I know what the timer is. The cause of our problems, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this magic water and transfer it to Jack for the Oaken Club, because I think Jack's going to need it most. And I'm going to call it into this episode. Next time we're going to find out what this thing in front of us is. But until then, I'm JKGSys14. Thank you for watching. Have a good day and adios.